Hello children, how are you? Hope you are fine at home. And today we are going to start with a new chapter. Okay, before that, whenever we think about maths, the immediate thing that comes to our mind are numbers. Yes, right from the day you come to school, from KG onwards, we read numbers, we learn numbers, 1, 2, 3, etc. All these numbers are used to count naturally. So they are called as natural numbers. What are the next set of numbers we learned? First is about natural numbers. Then, yes, we learned about whole numbers. See? Whole numbers includes natural numbers along with this zero. When zero is included along with that natural number, then we call that set, that group as whole numbers. After whole numbers, we didn't stop with that. See, we came into a situation, there is a sea and a cliff. Here people used to stand, no? Man can stand here. And we used to say that this cliff is 200 meters above sea level. And even below sea, we have mountains. Isn't it? Here, I need to measure below sea also. And this is 250 meters. What is the difference between above sea level and below sea level? When we come across such situation, we started differentiating above as positive quantity and below as negative quantity. So far, we know natural numbers and whole numbers. All these numbers had no sign, but now we came to a situation where we should have differentiation between two concepts, something above, something below, and similarly profit, loss, then right answer, wrong answers. Then what other situations? Left. So the right we will take it as positive. Anyhow, it all depends upon the situation how we consider. Okay, left side, right side. Okay, all these situations forced humans to have positive numbers as well as negative numbers. Along with these numbers, 1, 2, 3, he started including minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 250, minus 350. N numbers. So we got a new world of numbers, integers, and this was the first chapter we learned in class 7. Okay, we learned the properties of integers, we learned how to represent them in a number line. What is special about 0 here? 0 is an integer. It is neither positive nor negative. That's the special about 0. Is whole number an integer? Is every whole number an integer? Yes, every whole number is an integer. Every whole number is an integer. Is every integer a whole number? No. Only positive integers are whole numbers. Whereas this negative integers cannot be a whole number. They are not considered as whole number because they are negative. They come under the category of integers. Hope you understood how we learned about all these numbers right from class 1. Class 1 to class 6, we have learned all these numbers. Now in class 7, we learned integers. And again, here are one more situation where we have to think beyond integers. Okay, a distance of 750 meter above sea level. Now this is expressed as kilometer. How? 1 meter is equal to 1000 meter is equal to 1 kilometer. So what about 750 meter? It is 750 by 1000 kilometer. I'm converting this meter to 750 by 1000 kilometer. If I cancel this, we will have 1 5 is 5, 5 5 is 25, 20, 3 5 is 15, 4 by 4, 5 is 20. So this 750 meter is equal to 3 by 4 kilometer. If it is going to be an integer, you will say above sea level, so this is plus 750. But if I ask you to represent the same 750 meter in terms of kilometer, is it possible to represent in integers? Is this an integer? Is 3 by 4 an integer? Now I have come to a situation where I have a quantity that is not an integer. Okay? So, we are representing this 750 meter below sea level in kilometer using a new number, okay, that is 3 by 4. Can we denote the distance of 3 by 4 kilometer below sea level? Of course, it will be minus 3 by 4. And we have now come to a new world where we have one above and one below. And you all also know that one is numerator and one is denominator. The one which is on the top is numerator and which is in the bottom is denominator. So, and this word is called as rational number. So, how we define rational number? A rational number is defined as a number that can be expressed in the form P by Q. P by Q. Where P and Q are integers and Q not equal to 0. Surely the denominator should not be equal to 0. If I ask you in exam, what about a number minus 4 by 0? Is it a rational number? Surely it is not a rational number. Because rational number, the denominator should be not equal to 0. Not a rational number. Now, which is what numbers we are going to learn? It is all about rational numbers. Is it clear, children? How will we represent rational number? It will be of the form P by Q, where P and Q are integers. So, along with the word natural numbers, how is natural numbers denoted? By the letter N. Whole numbers, which include 0 along with this natural number. Integers, it is represented using the letter Z. Okay. What about rational number? We represent it using the letter Q. How is rational number represented using symbol? It is capital letter Q. All these letters are capital letters. You cannot define them using small letters. Universally, we use only capital letters. Mathematician fixed one sum. Constant symbols. Okay, children. Now, this integer, is every integer a whole number? Definitely not. But if every whole number is an integer. Similarly, is every integer a rational number? We will discuss in next slides. Is it clear, children? Okay. 4 by 5 is a rational number. Do you all agree with that? 4 by 5. Is a rational number. So far, you will say this as fraction. Isn't it? But now, you have learnt a new word, rational number, because it is of the form 4 by 5. Why do we call it as rational number? This fraction, we will talk about only when we have sharing, when we think about part of a whole. But this rational number, we can talk about something while we measure. See here in fraction, now only when we divide or share, we will talk about this fraction. But in rational number, it is all about measuring. How far, how much weight it is. It's going to be measuring. Okay. So you hope you understood the difference between these two. Now, is minus 3 by 4 also a rational number? Minus 3 by 4. Is this a rational number? Yes. It's a rational number. Is the number 2 by minus 3 a rational number? Yes. It's also a rational number. See, 2 is an integer. Minus 3 is also an integer. So, it is a rational number. Okay. All fractions are rational numbers. All fractions are rational numbers. Okay. Now, are integers also a rational number? Just now I asked you on previous slide. Are all integers a rational number? Integers, positive and negative whole numbers. Are they rational numbers? Yes, they are rational numbers. Because any integer, for example, minus 5, minus 4, or minus 100, all these integers, or plus 250, these are all integers, can be written with the denominator 1. Now I have written this minus 5 as minus 5 by 1. Both means the same. I have written in the form P by Q. Okay. So it is a rational number. Even think about 0. I can write 0 by 1. So 0 is a rational number which can be written as 0 by 1, which is of the form P by Q. Okay. How about decimal number? Now think about decimal number 0.2 or 1.5. Are they rational numbers? Or they are separate word? Something which does not come under whole number, integers, rational numbers. No children, every decimal number can be written in the form P by Q. See, 0.2 is nothing but 2 by 10. In the basics of decimals we learnt, no? Similarly, 1.5 can be written as 15 by 10. 12.008 can be written as 12008 divided by 1000. So, every decimal number can be written in the form of P by Q. Any decimal number that can be written in the form of P by Q are rational numbers. Okay, children? So, integers are also rational numbers. Decimal numbers are also rational numbers. Fraction numbers are also rational numbers. Okay? Hope it is clear what is rational numbers. Okay? Now, just now we learned, now as we have in integers positive and negative, here too we have positive and negative rational numbers. For example, plus 5 by plus 2 is a rational number. Plus 5 by minus 2, it's a rational number. Minus 5 by plus 2 is a rational number. Minus 5 by minus 2 is a rational number. Isn't it? Everywhere I have the same numbers, 5 by 2, 5 by 2, 5 by 2. Only thing is, it differs in signs. Now, this is a positive rational number. And this is a negative rational number. This one is also a negative rational number. And here, this one is a positive rational number. Okay, children? Is 8 by minus 3 a negative rational number? Yes, it is a negative rational number. What about minus 3 by minus 5? It is positive rational number. Or you have to write positive rational number. Okay, children? Now, we are going to find which of these are negative rational numbers. Circle out the negative rational numbers alone. Yes, this one is a negative rational number. What about 5 by 7? No, it's a positive. 3 by minus 5 is negative. 0 is neither positive nor negative. 6 by 11? It is also positive. What about minus 2 by minus 9? We have two negative signs. This is not a negative rational number. It will become positive rational number. How? If I multiply and by minus 1, both in the numerator and denominator, we will get 2 by 9. minus into minus.